Wounded gang leader Vince Focarelli is fast running out of options in his desperate attempt to attend the funeral of his slain son. He's now relying on an appeal to the Corrections Department after a judge refused his bid for bail on the grounds of public safety.
An urgent bid by a grieving father and gang leader to farewell his murdered son soon ends in defeat for Vince Focarelli's legal team. The Supreme Court refusing bail, meaning he can't attend tomorrow's funeral for his 22-year-old son, Giovanni. Both men sprayed with bullets at Dry Creek a fortnight ago. Focarelli listened to today's hearing from hospital, recovering from the fourth attempt on his life. He's charged with drug trafficking on the night of his son's murder and breaching bail for receiving phone calls from ally Michael Safiris. In those recorded calls from Yatala, the pair talked of boosting the new boys by making members convert to Islam, switching to European motorbikes and causing chaos. Focarelli's lawyers again argued he'd be a sitting duck in prison, but they say police could protect him at a funeral. Prosecutors opposed bail, saying Focarelli's a target and a protagonist in the bikie war. Justice Anne Vanstone agreed, ruling there's a threat of further violence and risk to public safety.
She found that although Vince Focarelli made a genuine and heartfelt request, and it's profoundly distressing that a father can't bury his son, in all the circumstances, she can't release him.
In another courtroom, a former Comanchero named as a suspect in the shooting of Giovanni Focarelli got permission to flee interstate, fearing for his safety. Focarelli's last hope of release for his son's funeral now rests with his application to the Corrections Department for compassionate leave. Jane Stinson, 10 News.
And that final decision from Correctional Services was expected late this afternoon. Court reporter Jane Stinson joins us live. Jane, will Focarelli be allowed to go to his son's funeral?
Well, Beck, it's still a possibility. 10 News understands that the Corrections Department still hasn't made a decision about that, but they intend to issue a public statement tomorrow. Now, they're waiting for further information from the police, including what the police involvement will be at the funeral. They say that the funeral is planned for a mosque, which is expecting hundreds of worshippers for Friday prayers. Now, it'll be a brave person who grants his freedom after two courts have now decided that it's simply too dangerous. What we do know, though, is that hospital security remains tight, with Vince Focarelli again moved to a different ward today.
Thank you, Jane. Jane Stinson reporting.